Dear friends in Christ Jesus, may the Lord bless you and give you peace. As we intensify our Lenten observance, today we have another biblical symbol for our reflection, that is thorn. The Latin word for thorn is spinum, which means something that pricks, that pokes, pierces, causing pain. Naturally, thorn is something that indicates negative, something undesirable and unpleasant. In the biblical context, thorn fundamentally denotes three realities: the physical pain, mental struggle, and spiritual sorrow for the sins committed. In the book of Genesis chapter 3, verse 17, God pronounces judgment on Adam on account of his disobedience, saying, "Cursed is the land because of you. In pain you shall eat of it. Thorns and thistles it shall bring forth, and you shall eat the plants of the field." Again, in the book of Numbers 33:55, God warns his people, telling them that if they do not obey his command and live accordingly, then his and their adversaries will become thorns in the flesh. St. Paul makes it all the more clear when he indicates that thorns means something that is struggling, something that irritates, and something that is to do with the struggles in life. He says in the letter to the Corinthians, second letter, chapter 12, verse 7, he says, "Therefore, to keep me from being too elated, a thorn was given in the flesh, a messenger of Satan to torment me." In the Gospels, the same metaphor of thorns continues to connote something that blocks and hinders the progress in the spiritual life. The perfect example is shown in the parable of the sowers in the Gospel account of St. Mark chapter 4, verse 1. In the end, thorn, as a symbolic representation of a continual inner struggle and annoyance in life, culminates in the Passion of Christ, when the cruel authority meted out their last fury of contempt, mockery, and insult by placing on his head a woven crown of thorns. All the synoptic gospels recall this awful event in their account. Yes, dear friends, coming to our own life, in our personal struggles, conflict, even the insults and mockery and the pains of life that others at times intend on us can become bearable, can become a strength and source of our force, if only we place them at the crown of our Lord Jesus. The Latin expression summarizes it all: "Corona et spinis peccata sunt," meaning our sins are Jesus' crown of thorn. If so, may our sincere Lenten observance become our passionate participation in the Passion of Christ.